So this is the first in the series of how to use ICON. And what we're going to look at today is how to find a newspaper article that we can use in a debate or a project like that. The first thing I'm going to do, and you don't have to do it this way, but if you click on High School Resources, this allows us to choose exactly what resource we want to use. And you'll notice there are a bunch of different categories here. And what we're concerned with today is newspapers right here. You can select an individual newspaper. So if I wanted to learn something about local Connecticut history or an issue that's happening in Hartford, I can click on Hartford Current. But for our purpose, I'm going to click on ICON Newsstand. This is going to allow us to search a bunch of different newspapers at once. It's also a nicely redesigned interface. It looks fantastic. Right here, this little button that says Full Text. That's going to make sure that the articles that we locate are readable online. So I don't have to go anywhere else to read the actual article. And so when I put in a search, and in this case, we'll do something on AIDS in Africa, you'll notice that recent searches pop up below. So maybe someone else has done this search before you successfully. And if I click on AIDS, Africa, and HIV, you notice I get 3,600 different results, which is a lot of results. There's a couple ways I can narrow this down to make these results more useful to me. First thing I could do is I could look at these subjects here, and maybe some of these subjects fit exactly what I'm looking for. Something that I think is very important as a former social studies teacher is how recent the article is. And so you can see the articles range from 1986 to today. And so what I might do is I might lower the search so that the article is from 2004 to 2012. Now, if I hit update, you'll see I get a lot less results, like 1,689 results. So that's a lot better. I can also drill down further by the publication itself. If I like the New York Times, which I do, I can click that, and it will give me New York Times articles. I'm now down to 176 results. In scanning this list, I can look at the date, I can look at the title, and maybe it finds what I'm looking for. But let's say Grandmothers from Africa Rally for AIDS Orphans. Maybe this is something that I'm interested in. I can click preview, and without even clicking the button, it pops up a little summary of what I can look at through the abstract. The abstract is essentially a short summary of what the article is about to see if I'm interested in it or not. If I click the article, let's say I am interested in it, the abstract is again displayed, and then I have full text. I can translate this into other languages. If I want to print this, I'm going to click this button first. And the reason being is because it will format this to fit to a printable document. You can see it pops up rather quickly in the browser. I can also click citation. And so all I have to do is select the citation style, which at Sheehan High School, we use MLA, and we'll pick the newest edition. I hit change. And there it goes. And this is the piece that I need for my Works Cited page, right there for you. You may also save it as a PDF file, which I recommend. It's a lot easier than some of these other ones. And if you have RefWorks or some of these other citation managers, you can also download it to them as well if you're doing some high-level research. So if I click PDF, you'll see I can include citation information. I hit continue. And in just a moment, we should see it pop up. And there it is. There's a pop-up window that you can't see. It has given me a PDF file. So that's searching for a newspaper article on icon.org.